Hello, everybody. How are you? Nice to have you in the other side and ready for your tango class, okay, with Patricio and Eva. So we do this every Saturday. And today we are going to teach the agarrada. The agarrada is something that you hold and you move, or you catch, the catch.
Agarrada was also my, I had a neighbor. She was agarrada. Agarrada is somebody that doesn't want to spend money too. You know, when somebody is like cheap, that they don't want to spend any money, yeah. They say, hey, you are agarrada.
Yeah, correct, yes.
Ser agarrado es también la persona que no, que le gusta guardar el dinero y no quiere gastar.
As agarrada also is when two people fight, like they have a big discussion argument. Of something, argument, so
sí, se agarraron. Yes.
Yeah, exactly. So before we go to, before we start with the class, I wanted to say thank you to my beautiful friend, Cristina Delon. I know you're always there for your beautiful jewelry. If you're interested in Cristina jewelry, just go to her catalog and go through it. You will find so many amazing things.
Tonight you are dressed like a typical tanguera. You are the personification of the tango woman.
Yeah, maybe.
Black and red. What a classic combination.
Yes.
Yeah. Our studio is filled with posters, tango posters, and several of them they feature a woman in red and black.
Correct. Very good.
It's
yeah.
Really something so traditional, so classic.
For tango, yeah. Yeah. I was almost all black, but I say that's kind of dark.
Well, so. I'm wearing the colors today.
It's like a little bit down, so yeah, red, I think. As a combination is good.
Yes, beautiful. Okay. So let's see who is with us today. I got a feeling that I know who is with us, but because they're always there. But let's say hello to our friends.
Yes.
Vamos a decirle hola a los amigos. Ahora te digo, y a las amigas. Ahora te digo, ¿quién está con nosotros hoy? Tom Lee dice, hi, Patricio and Eva. Tom. Hello, Tom, how are you? We look forward to see you next Friday. We are dancing again. Mm-hmm. Richard from Canada. Hola, I'm on time for a change. I am on time for a change. Very nice. Good. Thank you for joining us early.
Thank you, Richard.
Good. Yes. So how about we get into what we're here to do?
Yes.
And that is to dance.
Mm-hmm. Let's dance a little bit. And then we're going to share some information with you so you learn something new maybe today.
El sol hace mucho me alegraba de día, hoy me alegra en la noche la caricia lunar, mi bohemia se hunde en su melancolía, mi bohemia la busca misteriosa y fatal, si estoy solo en mi pieza, en mi lúgubre pieza, soledad que matizan cigarrillo y café, abro bien la ventana y la luna me besa. Y te besa la luna con tu beso de fe. Vieja luna, que me brindas la fortuna de tu plata y tu bondad. Vieja luna, que quiero como a ninguna, como nadie te querrá. Tú sabes que es un secreto la pena que un día de luna llena suavemente te conté. Vieja luna, te quiero como a ninguna, como a nadie más querré.
I hate to run away from your embrace, baby, but we had to get back to the class.
We had to get back to the class, yes.
Yeah, a little bit of dancing and a little bit of sharing and instruction. Mm-hmm. Let me fix this up a little bit. Hey, Rebecca is also here.
Rebecca, mm-hmm. Nice.
Yeah, hola, Rebecca. Sí, sí, Milonga, May 7th, Tom. I guess that's for Eva, the cabeceo, but yeah, you know, I'm also open to a cabeceo every once in a while. So, you want some mate, Eva?
Okay, yeah, why not? Thank you. Mm. I love mate. I drink it every day.
Gracias. Just wanted to make sure that we have good audio level.
Good.
Everything is looking good here on the screen. So, en la agarrada.
Agarrada.
A simple
parezco
concept.
Alfonsín, ¿te acordás?
Alfonsín, yes.
La agarrada.
La agarrada. A simple concept of grabbing your partner's foot. Okay? For example, as you do a back ocho and her foot is exposed there, you come here over the side, and you just put the foot over the top and over, and that is what an agarrada is. It is preceding a barrida. A barrida always begins with catching the foot. So you first have to grab your partner's foot and then do the sweep. You cannot do one without the other. But la agarrada is a concept in itself. It doesn't have to be followed by a barrida, although it can. There are ways of doing the agarrada just by itself. Because, for example, right here I go, that's right there. And I simply step back. And then you step over. Mm-hmm. Right? So I cut your foot, bring the dance to a stop. That means not that we stop dancing, it means that we stop moving in the space. But we're going to lock into that position. Then I simply step behind. And then you are on a cross position. And then now you begin your embellishment. You begin your transition onto the front, mm-hmm. and I might pivot and just follow with some more walk.
Yeah, or as walking. We are going to teach agarrada also so you lead the lady to do an agarrada
yes.
with your foot, so agarrada it's as we
from
walk.
The follows. Yes.
Exactly, yeah.
So in this way, the introduction of this element, the fact that I just grab your foot, it changes everything, and because of that, then there are other things that happen. So that gives, in a way, a reason to the dance. Because just put something in there, and then a lot of things have to shape around that one element. Mm-hmm. Something as simple as this. For example, we can do a step back, a pivot, and then agarrar the foot. And then step back, a pivot, and grab the foot. Mm-hmm. One and two. And one and two. Here you cross over, you do a pasada, and you got something nice right there. Out of the ordinary, not as common as doing a sequence just the same way is being shown for decades, you know what I mean? You just sprinkle a little bit of a couple of tango elements and then the whole thing becomes a total different element, mm-hmm. a total different combination. Let's do that again. So, side step. The lead goes forward with the right foot. The follow goes back with her left foot. You're gonna have to step far enough as to have a position here where you can lead the follow to turn.
Yeah.
And before you begin your movement leads, the follow has to be led back. If you try to do both at the same time, it's gonna be very difficult. For the follow, it's very important, ladies, here that you have a good disassociation and that you understand that the shoulder precedes the hip. Because when the lead is on this corner here and he's trying to lead you to turn around like that, at some point you have to pivot back. I tell you this because sometimes I'm dancing and I'm leading back ochos like this. This is a back ocho on the side. Let's just take a look at this. How interesting concept.
Mm-hmm.
I can lead ochos with you in front of me, But if I cross my leg, I can do the same thing in a different plane. This is mind-boggling for some people, you see, because they haven't explored different positions of the legs, different positions of the body. Not all ochos have to be accompanied by the lead moving with you.
Yeah.
Sometimes I stay on one foot and I lead the ocho regardless. Sometimes I'm in this position here and my partner is doing ochos on my flank. I could be moving like this and leading front ochos too.
Oh yeah.
Catch! See how interesting. It's a game changer.
Yeah, of course. Yeah.
Because whatever is happening, you grab that foot, you stop, and then from there, you move on to a different place.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
So, where I'm just now, ramifications are so many, especially inside my brain, that...
We don't want to know all of them.
No, just the tango one. So here, you're doing back ochos, you see? So when the lead is up far in the corner, trying to bring the follow around like that, at some point the follow needs to understand that this disassociation here is for you to follow with a pivot, right? Because otherwise the lead has to swing the arm so far around. So here you have an advantage here. You step far, she turns, then you come and grab that foot.
Yeah, and also, can I say something about it?
Yes.
You stay far, you stay, actually, the lead stay farther than the follow, because it's like, you treat a little bit this like you want me to center, kind of center with you, not really go as long as you, right? Because you want to manage to turn me here, so we still use like a triangle shape.
Yes.
Our footwork.
If the figure resembles an oval or a racetrack, I would be on the outer circle.
Yes.
And then you will be always on the inside, right?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
So if we remember the Olympics, for example,
yeah,
I will be on the far outside. Right there, I can make her turn, come grab that foot.
Mm-hmm.
If I bring my partner back, she will stand up and go. And this, my friend Milongueros, don't lose
your cool?
No, your cool. Yeah, the cool. Don't lose your cool, because this can be done in close embrace. Please, come in. And it's nice because as the lead lifts up, the follow is moved back far away to the point that she lifts up her foot. Mm. The follow has to be aware of the balance between axis
during the weight transfer
and leaning. Because if you are a purist and you always want to be in your axis, you're going to have to be far from your partner. Mm-hmm. But if the follow is a little bit of a hybrid of a milonguero and a salon, then the follow might be at times in her axis and at times be okay with leaning over the lead. I tell you this for our friends there that are always thinking about being light. Sometimes the lead wants your weight, he wants to hold it, and you can then push your body into him and don't be too concerned about your weight. Because right here, as I lift up, Eva is going to push her weight on me to pick up that front foot. See, right here, this is a nice moment for a pile. As she pulls her foot up, I have now this open space here, you see? And then we walk. Mm-hmm. You want to show a close-up of that?
Okay, yes, let's do that.
I'm going to look at the screen here, since I'm here in the technical corner of the studio, and see what our friends are saying. Huh? So guys, leave us a note here, because this is the only way we can hear from you. And actually, I was thinking today about taking calls. If one of you wants to be up here in the air, we can arrange for a phone call and you can come up and join us here in this. Good, I'm gonna bring the footwork. There we go. So what's the point here? The point is to step outside, pivot the follow, look for that foot. She stands up, open the space, I pass through here. One and two and three and four and one and two, and three, and four. Here, I have two chances. I slide that foot, barrida, look for an enganche, and enjoy that. Or, the other option we have is to sandwich the foot, open left, and bring the following to beautiful pasada over. Let's do it again. See here, I did this agarrada. I hold my hand on her back to not let her move away from me. And then I'm gonna transfer her weight off a little bit so I can initiate this barrida. And then as she separates, I keep going far and offer the back of my knee for a leg wrap, for example.
Yeah.
Let's do it one more time. Mm-hmm. Notice here, however, pivots with her feet together and then she reaches back. See that extension there? That is so important so as to not to fall first. If you don't put your leg back first, you won't be able to control your weight and you will make me fall. But if you reach back, then the lead enters here and then there is something to be said at the weight transfer here between these two places. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, Patricio turns me quite a bit. So please don't send your partner away from you.
¿Cómo decís, mi amor?
Que vos me mandás alrededor, cerca tuyo, me sobregirás para que yo no me vaya lejos cuando me vas a hacer el catch de la pierna, del pie.
Okay.
So that's very important because if not, it feels that we are all of a sudden too far from each other. So from the first ocho, when we do the first ocho here, it's like we are going back like 180 degrees, basically, for you to have an idea how much the follow needs to turn and come back over her own previous step.
But okay? I bet that carries a nice sensation, right?
It is very nice.
Because it feels nice here to cross like this, heel over the shoulder, and then get over like that and pivot. Because you build all about that power in you.
Yeah.
One, two, three. It just feels nice.
Yeah. So, but be sure that the lead, that you don't send your partner away. So that's the point that I want to make. Because if you don't pay attention, you send her away.
Oh, I see. Yes, yes.
Then the barrida will not happen. You will feel like you are not in, but because you're not in the right position, you will be too far from each other.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
I think it has to do a lot with the disassociation of the follow and the power of the waist. Waist power, right?
Yes.
It's waist power.
It's core, yeah. It's the core, yeah. It's the core, yeah. Because when we create this,
yeah. Okay. Yeah, porque Eva, I tell you this based on my experience when I dance with Eva. Eva has a lot of waist power here, and then the disassociation, she wraps very small turn. If you go like this, and then you wide, and you make a wide turn because your legs separate, you're gonna be slow and heavy. So the closer you are to the center of the turn, the quicker you will be. So it's important that you turn close to your left foot, and then go back. And when you walk back, try to think about crossing your right heel over to your left ischia, and then your left over to the right. When you do your ochos, and you not only just step back, but back and across, and across, and across, you are then getting one more, an eighth of a turn.
Yeah.
right? Extra.
Yeah.
Let's show them that from a top view camera, Eva.
Okay.
I want you to please. Go backwards. Yes. Yeah. And we show them how
so
you.
So Patricio,
cross.
What is Patricio saying that instead of this at the end of the turn, the way you do a molinete is the same thing, right? So instead of going just straight in the same track, like you are walking straight just back, you want to cross to the other, to the same line that the other leg is supporting your weight, yeah? So you're not there straight, you're crossing your leg in the same line. So you're going a little in diagonal, okay? So if I do that, and I will show you how we apply this during the turn, right? I will do it one more time. So instead of going completely back, we go a little bit crossing. Like, okay, this, or sometimes more, right? It depends how much we need to turn. So in this particular turn that we are doing right now, when Patricio sent me around here, I finish my turn and I go there. So I don't go straight to where my hips are pointing because it might take me away from him. So I finish my turn in the same line that my front leg is, okay? And I would say that this pretty much applies for any, every time you do this step molinete, in any molinete you do. It's kind of the, it's the same time technique. It's not only for this particular step that we are working right now.
You want to do it one more time from over there, going back into that corner? Yes.
This is the first, which is not the one that puts me back. This one?
Yeah.
Okay.
I just want people to see what a lovely position you get when you're there.
And I
then
change.
You want to do the second one?
And here, I don't want to hit you. There.
Just that. Look, stay there, right there. See this? This is beautiful. This crossbody going all the way to the bottom here, to the foot, coming back as a spiral all through the spine. Just lovely. Lovely. Perfect, Eva. So, it's kind of like she wraps into herself. See, there's a little crossing there. It's not just waist. It's not just pivot. It's pivot and the crossing of the leg in the way that your teacher is demonstrating perfectly. So that's what, ladies, that's what you have to work on when you do your ochos. It's obviously, it's optional, but it's not just for the follow, the leads too. This ability of crossing, crossing your leg when you're doing an ocho, it gives you an advantage of about an eighth more of a turn or a revolution, an eighth of a revolution, sometimes even a quarter, because you can cross a lot. So
yes.
Something that is out of reach for your waist pivot will be within reach because you add that cross.
Right.
Back saccadas benefit from that a lot.
Yes.
You add to the range.
It's the mobility in the hip, yeah?
Yes, do you want to turn your dial more first, and then you want to add that? But in the case that you find yourself pushing a lot for turning your vertebrae, I'm thinking, oh, this is impossible. How can I turn that much? Well, it's not just in one vertebrae. This is all through the vertebrae going up into the high back as we turn more extremely and even crossing the leg. Sometimes there are movements that don't need that crossing. So then you can do them just stepping back.
Of course.
But if you like the turn out, if you like the solid engagement into the hip, there's a lot of benefits for incorporating this.
It's part of the range of motion of the lapis that we were working in one of the last
yes.
lessons, in where you need to know, you need to understand all the positions, all the possibilities you have doing a simple lapis as this, because you can cross it behind the other leg as well. See that? So you utilize the full range motion that you have in those hips to be more precise and you do a variety of steps that without it, they're not, just not possible or they don't feel good, yeah.
Well, as you do this, what I'm trying to say to people, I'm trying to tell to follows, is that you have to be prone to turn your hips, your waist quickly. That you have to have overreacting waist. There is nothing wrong with being overreactive in the waist. Because the worst that can happen is that you just turn more, and then the lead has to then fine-tune his lead to the responsiveness of the follow. But if the follow is really heavy and there is nothing that makes her turn her waist, then I don't know, a lot of people are interested in that.
Yeah.
But for example, if you turn quick right there, it makes it easier. It facilitates a lot of the things.
Of course. And that's very advanced to understand, actually, if you want to work in, you know, in the step up in the level of understanding, it's like saying that when we walk and we pivot, those things happen in a different time. So we use different timings to accomplish that. We don't move like a ferry, like a boat, like it's a constant moving. We have accelerations, and this is decelerations of what we are doing. So from point A to point B in the music, when you feel out that time between this step and the final step, you will not utilize the same continuous, monotonous movement in your body, right? I will not go just like... It's not like a continuous motion. There is different speeds in the middle. So I might take this step, and then here, you know, it's kind of acceleration and deceleration, because I want to be ready for the next step. So if I had to step back, I better be ready before I extend that leg and I put my weight. So the pivot in the middle usually goes in a faster speed, and then slow down to achieve the perfect timing when you step. Okay, that's pretty advanced, but if you analyze your dance, you probably will discover the same thing, right? So
we need to make some slow motion videos to explain that at some point, because what you're talking about is so fast. You know, we're talking about the pivot and the extension,
yes,
right? Make this quick, so then you can
do
that slow.
Yeah, exactly. So it's just the calculation, like physically calculate and move at different speeds.
How much time you spend pivoting and how much time you spend transferring the weight.
Yes.
Absolutely. So a very, very interesting point, Eva. Thanks for that tip. I bet people are appreciate that kind of information.
Yeah.
It's what makes a difference, really. Mm-hmm. Good. I hope they can visualize this. So, how about you dance with me?
Yeah, let's dance. Let's apply what we are.
That was fun.
That was fun and fast.
And fast. Well, no tanto. ¿Cómo están nuestros amigos latinoamericanos y argentinos? ¿Eh? Yo estoy acá, no estoy seguro si sale el audio. Sí, sale.
¿No con este o...?
Sí, le estoy diciendo hola a los amigos latinoamericanos, que todavía no veo muchos comentarios de español. ¿Será que están todos de fiesta?
Tal vez. Eso sería bueno.
Sí, claro, por supuesto. Bueno, como vieron, ahí le marqué a Eva un adorno para que ella me agarre al pie a mí. That is a very nice step that you can do.
Yeah, I really like doing that one, yeah. It's very playful, huh? No, it's pretty cute.
There is so much going on there.
Yes.
The follow has to understand what it is to project and what it is to transfer weight. What it is to project and what it is to transfer weight. If the follow only understands this much, this won't happen. This only happens when you can distinguish that within your axis you are being asked to move, to extend your leg, possibly have 10%, 20% of your weight off the standing leg and onto the outer leg, and then from there be able to lift it up, okay? Because the lead has to make the follow derail a little bit. You're going to be, this happens as the follow advances. Mm-hmm. And as the follow is advancing, you start leading a slight figure S away from you and towards you, away from you and towards you. And when the follow comes towards you, what you can do there is you make her, yes, you make her step forward with a slight cross, and then you lead her slightly to the side. So she comes outside your foot.
Here, but in this case, we are working in agarrada, right? So I will grab your foot.
I don't really have much control over what you do with that, because we lead energy. You are the one in charge of precisely doing the detail of the movement, right? But what I can do is to signal her that this is a side step. This is a front side, front side, front side, because there is a slight. Then she walks away from me and then towards me, front side, front side. Beautiful, you see, and she can alternate and play with that.
Exactly.
Because I only lead that energy goes out, goes out, goes out, goes out. That's what I'm leading. Mm-hmm. What she does is up to her, literally. Now, this is not easy. No. Because the lead also has to understand what it is to project, what it is to be on a split weight, and what it is to transfer the weight back and seat, like weight there. Normally, we want to do this and then we will collect when we are at that point. But I'm bringing the couple here to the end of this back step. Mm-hmm. And I make a point of leaving my foot on the floor so my partner can then do the agarrada.
Exactly.
Right? First thing that is first, she has to have something to grab in order to grab, right? So if I keep pulling my foot away, if I pull my foot away, she won't be able to grab it,
no,
right?
You would just be like a walking step, yeah.
Now, for you guys that are there and you understand about the precision and the timing, you can do this in two ways. If this is the tempo in which you're walking, the follow have to go like this. So after the beat, on the following eighth of a note, she goes front side. Right? So she will go one, eight, two, three, and one, eight, two, and three, and four, and one, eight, two, and three, and four. On the one, eight. One, eight, two, and three, and four, and one, eight. Sometimes it works better when you do and one, two, and three, and four, and one. So you can make a step forward early as you go and one, two, three, and three, and four, and one, and two, and three, and four, and one, and two, and three, and four. Or you can do this. One and two and three and four, and one and two and three and four, and one and two and three and four. Okay, so this is 1A or N1. Mm-hmm. Let's dance again?
Yes.
Okay, corazón. Este es un lindo tango. Thank you.
corazón me estás mintiendo, corazón, ¿por qué lloras? No me ves que estoy muriendo de esta pena tu compás. Si sabes que ya no es mía, que otros brazos entregó, no desmayes todavía, sé constante como yo. Dame tu latido, que yo quiero arrancar esta flor de olvido que ya ha prendido sobre mi mar. Corazón, no la llames ni la implores, que de tus amores nunca ha merecido tanta humillación. Creo en Dios y la vida con sus vueltas. Sé que de rodillas la traerá a mis puertas a pedir perdón.
Nice. We are back.
Nice, nice, nice. Okay, as you can see, I'm playing a little bit with that idea, right? Sometimes I open my legs, sometimes I go straight for the catch. Sometimes I go small. You can also go higher with the leg. So you have different options to embellish that moment, okay? During those catches.
Is there any other variety that we can show on this? Oh, the three, yes. We discussed the three sacadas into a parada, into a agarrada.
Okay. Okay. Do it. Quitate del navarrido? No.
Mm-hmm.
Ah, I see.
One, two, three. Let's do it one more time. In either
it's
direction.
Similar to the other.
Yes.
It's just that you're coming from a turn.
One, two, three. Yes.
You did the same one.
One, two, three. And here the sandwich and the passing can take place.
Mm-hmm. You did it with the barrida as well, yeah.
Yes.
We were doing things with barridas,
yes.
Like, everything like catching but and doing different.
If the lead brings the follow to the cross, and from there, he enters the turn with sacadas, with the left foot first, one. Mm-hmm. He has one sacada here, two, second sacada here. Then here, he's in a very similar position. He turns the shoulder, and then comes here and grabs that foot. But look at the overreach here, outside you. Mm-hmm. The fact that this is far, or relatively far, is what makes this step look like this. Because mm-hmm. I have to separate my leg and go reach far, yeah. And then step over for the sandwich and then reopen.
Yeah, it requires nice extension, yeah.
If it's out of reach because the lead lets the follow or leads the follow too far, or the follow does not close the turn. Mm-hmm. One, two, three, four, five. This is something that the follows have to program their minds to do. One, two, three, four, five. And then you can close a triangle into a turn. Mm-hmm. One, two, three, four, five. That way the distance will not be too much. If the second step, for whatever reason,
we should use the upper coming.
One, two, if the follow goes far on the second step, then this will be out of reach.
Impossible.
And there is no point in that. Mm-hmm. But the natural distance of the triangulation really is acceptable and it's actually within the distance. Okay? So for to a certain level, one, two, three, four, five, I go reach that far.
Okay.
Barrida. I'll go one, two, three, four, five. At that point, I'm stopping my partner and I got possession of her foot. Sandwich, and then open. Don't bring your partner with you. Respect her axis. Keep your hands with her. Then at that point, she can step over, pasada, and then the flow will tell you what is next. But if we are here in this position,
show the shape of the shape.
Here we go, one, two.
Triangle.
One, two, three. You see, my partner is closing the circle around me. She is there, you see? That is not going away from me. Going away from me is going perpendicularly away from this orbit.
If I was here, yeah.
That will be out of reach. Mm-hmm. Yes, go back there, please. You see that left foot over there? That is out of reach. It's not in the interest of this circulation here. She wants to come this way to be with me.
So keep your partners close, guys, and you girls use your hips. Yeah.
You see, my partner is transferring her weight, and as she transfers to the far side, it's not going any further. Because she is in the orbit, then pivot, and now I grab the foot as she steps back. You see that triangulation? She just stepped where I stepped before. I sandwich here, and I open there. Look here, lots of stuff. Gancho. Franocho. This can be done on both sides. Mm-hmm. The richness of this is that you can do left and right. One, two, three, four, five. See, that foot is right there. I caught it. Here, there's a movement that I like to do. Barrida, sweep through that. Go further than the follow. And then she will leg wrap. And then step back. Maybe. Or maybe we stay there.
Yeah.
Okay.
One, two, three, four, five, six. Barrida, you can see very well. I slide. Close.
We did that. I see.
Leg wrap. Well, a refresher is
I like it. No, it's very good actually. Yeah. Yeah. Okay.
Okay. Good. I think we're making progress. Ooh, 7:54 already. Okay, before we forget. Oh, Celeste. Un saludo para Celeste que está con
Celeste.
Nosotros. Desde Buenos Aires, mi madre querida. Okay, well, okay, aquí estamos. Bueno, un beso para mi mamá que me está mirando por la televisión. A pleasure to have you with us, Celeste. Here is two signs, one at the top, one at the bottom. They are there just to serve as a reminder of that one thing that you could do if you like to tune in on Saturday evenings and find Tango Live. We continue to make our efforts to share what we know with all of you, our friends, and everybody in the world at no cost to you. So we all ask you, we only ask you if you can and you are enjoying the classes, make a donation, and that will make sure that we can continue to do this for all of us.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, any amount is good. You know, it can be a latte or anything. It doesn't need, whatever you feel like you can donate is good. Also, you can contribute if you can, liking our page, following us, or, you know, putting what you feel about our classes or stuff like that. All of those things help us, you
yes.
know, to reach more people.
Promotion and visibility
promotion.
Go
yeah.
a long
so
way
So that's
as
another
well.
Way you can help us as well, yeah.
Great. I want to dance a little bit more.
Yeah, me too.
So we're going to try to do all of them. We're going to try to do them in the turn, and we're going to try to do them in the straight line with the embellishment. And there is also one in the boleo that we haven't shown. Ah, qué rico matecito. Bueno, voy a sacar este cartel. There you go. Nice pose. ¿Qué bailamos?
Algo que no nos corte Facebook.
Bueno. Thank you.
cuál es el camino que ilumina tatazón. Si parece que el destino más lo alarga para mi dolor, y ese verde suelo donde crece el cardo, lejos toca el cielo donde está mi amor. Y de vez en cuando mido para que lo envidie yo. Vida mía, lejos más te quiero, vida mía. Piensa en mi regreso, sé que el oro no tendrá tu beso, si es por eso que te quiero más, vida mía. Si hasta por el aliento, acercando el momento de acariciar felicidad, sos mi vida. Y quisiera llevarte a mi lado prendida, y así ahogar mi soledad. Ya parece que la huella su color.
Se acabó.
Y saliendo la
se acabó el tango, nada más. Tenemos unos minutos, todavía tenemos como 10 minutos.
Wow.
Sí, por suerte.
Okay.
10 more minutes. 10 more minutes. We're not going away. No, we're not going away. 10 more minutes. So get back up, put that glass away and get to work.
¿Qué era lo que querías? ¿Había algo más que querías mostrarle?
I want to start the group classes soon.
Ah.
If you're in Seattle and you want to join us for our group classes, I'm thinking about coming back. So drop us a message, let us know you're interested, and we'll try to form the group for our tango friends in the region. We continue with classes on Tuesday. Eva is teaching a beautiful technique class. Since I started taking that class, I'm more flexible now. Now I'm almost like Eva.
Yes.
What do you laugh?
No, I know you feel better.
Those who are taking the class are my witness.
No, for sure, I see my own students the progress when I see them dancing tango afterwards. Like, it changed. It's a big change in the control they have of their own bodies. You know, it's very crystal clear for me that the conditioning and the work that you give to your body pays out when you dance. You know?
It's a great conversation. You know, is dancing enough to make you a better dancer, or you have to do dancing and conditioning as well?
Mm-hmm.
Right?
Yeah.
It's something that some people have different opinions on, but definitely the Eva's class will help you to increase your range of motion, your balance, body awareness, and strengthening, because strengthening is what allows you to fight for your balance and the positions, and to maintain the body in the place under stress, the stress of the dynamics. So you can join us. We are going live on Tuesdays at 6 p.m. through Zoom, but you have to register. This is not an open class like today's class. This is a class for a small group of people. So if you're interested in joining us, also drop us a line. We are trying to get caught up with all the advertisement and promotion, but it's like a lot of work to get all of that done. So if you want to reach out and let us know that you're interested in the class, we don't have to do all that extra work that we are not interested in doing.
Right?
Yes. So let's go back to this movement here in the agarrada. There is a movement right there here. When you do a boleo, if you separate your leg right there, you have the chance to grab the foot on the outside, the foot of the lead. One, two, three, right there. And if you really feel like you want to change where things are going, you can actually drag his leg and do a barrida and put it right there.
Yeah,
okay. Really nice. A tanguero that is not very open to negotiations will not like it.
Well,
but that
also
is his problem or her problem.
Yeah. Also, you cannot actually drag a leg that it has weight, so it has to, certain things has to be in order for that to happen.
Well, assuming that the lead is putting his weight off this leg as he is led a boleo, then that will lead you into an Americana, which allows to flow out of this very easily. But it really feels like you participate of the making, and sometimes it's quite fun. If the like any conversation, if the conversation has a certain flow, it's okay to change that subject.
Yeah, of course.
And this is what it is. This is, let's say, okay, let's change the subject. You have the right to change the subject as much as any other participant in the conversation. Mm-hmm. Now, but if we're always cutting each other off, then we probably won't go anywhere. So the idea is that we are open to the conversation and we see where it takes us. Some conversations are more challenging than others. So the goal here is to go somewhere with this play.
Yeah.
Like that. If your partner is always leads you in the same way and you know already what he's gonna do, and you dance already a number of times at the milonga, and you know that he likes to do that, followed by that, and then finish with that, then one day you can say, barrida, we are doing barridas, baby.
Let's change the game.
Let's change it a little bit, of course, right? So, you follows can do the agarrada alone, and then step over through that. Or if you wish, you can do agarrada, check that your lead is not gonna fall off, and then take his foot. If the boleo was on an accent and it's followed by a soft music, even better.
Exactly.
You could do it playfully, softly, carefully.
Well, I think that's the only way you can do it if it's not left, if you just want to bring to the table something different. Because if not, you like just make him fall. So obviously you need to kind of have the mood, you know, I feel like, oh, here I have the time to do something. Instead of doing something yourself, you incorporate the other person to the embellishment you are trying to do, and it changed the whole thing, as Patricio said. Yeah, but for sure I will not try it in
after a rush.
One beat, like chum pum 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 pum. Oh yeah, babe. You know, I was like, no.
Yeah, it's risky.
It's risky.
It's risky. Yes. All right. So you got another one more version there. I think we should finish this with a dance.
Okay, it sounds good to me.
Okay. Vamos a buscar una canción linda.
Que no nos corten.
Ah, ¿quién sabe eso? ¿Qué bailamos? Esta, una fija.
Una.
Thank you. Thank you for that dance. That was beautiful.
That was beautiful.
We are saying goodbye to everybody.
Yes,
we have Abby Hadar, we have Daria Consiglieri, José Manuel, Tom Lee, Rebecca, Celeste, Wesley, John, everybody, the whole family there. Yes.
Good. Okay. So, hi, thank you. Thank you guys for being there. Let's see each other next weekend, okay? Have a great week. Take care.